Hello friends, in this video we are going to see what is the difference between RLs, RL state and then RLs through of optional. And in the last video we saw what is optional and how to use it. And if you have not watched that video, I would strongly suggest you to watch that video before watching this. And let's get into their topic. So the difference between RLs, RL state and RL throw is optional RLs is something that we use to return a default value when an optional has no value in it. And RLs get is something that we use to invoke a supplier when an optional has no value in it. When I say supplier, it could be a functional interface. And in the Lambda video series, we saw what is functional interface and how to invoke it using Lambda expression. And I would also suggest you guys to watch that video if you do not know what I'm talking about. And that's what RLs get does. And then RLs throw is something that throws exception when optional has no value in it. And let's see the difference between these three with an example. So I have this main class, and let me erase this. So let me create an optional, and then let me go ahead and explain the difference between those three. So that's it. So here what I have done is I have created an optional string. That means optional is a container which can have a string value in it. So what I did is I have just declared this field, and then I have a value to it, and using that I have created an optional. So I have an optional reference which is book value. So if I want to print the value that is inside the optional, I would use get method. Let me use that. So if I run this, it will print Java 8. So basically what get did is it got the value that was inside the optional. So that's what get will do. But so this get will throw exception if this optional does not hold any value in it. So let me show you that. So what I did is I just made it as a null. So that means my optional container does not have any value, but I'm still invoking get. So let me see what happens now. Yes, it threw that exception. So it threw no such element exception. That means that get is expecting a value in the optional. If you want to handle this scenario, that means you are not sure whether there is a value in an optional or not, but you know that if in case there is no value, you want to return a default value or some meaningful value that you know you're aware of. So in that case, what you can do is you can use RLs. So in that RLs, mention Java 8. So that means here, it's going to invoke the value in the optional. If optional does not return any value, or if it has no value in it, then it would return what you are, we have mentioned in RLs. So let me run this. Check that. Yeah, it has returned a value. So that means this Java 8 is something that we got from the RLs. If you want to make sure that it is returned only when there is a null value, we can give a meaningful value here. Let's call it. So that means a book has Oracle value in it. So in this case, RLs will not even get fired. So let me show you that. So here it returns Oracle because it optional has a meaningful value. So RLs will not even return any value because optional itself has a meaningful value. So that's what RLs will do, like we have discussed. So, and now let me explain you what RL's get will do. So like I've already mentioned, RL's get will take an a supplier. So it could be a functional interface, and it will invoke the functional interface abstract method. Let me show you how it will work. So created an interface, and it has a single abstract method which qualifies this as an functional interface. And let me so what I have done here is basically I'm invoking RL's get, and also I'm supplying this lambda expression. So what it does is basically it gives implementation for this book service interface, and then since it is returning a value, so whatever I pass here will be returned back. And so this is how we use RL's get. Let me go ahead and run this. Okay, so we have got Java 8, because Java 8 is something that I have given implementation for the functional interface. That's what got invoked when this found no value in this book optional container. So so if you want to make sure that it is not returning Java 8. See, both the expressions I have now given Oracle, because there is valid value in the optional. So that's what this will do. And let's see what RL's throw will do. So let me call this RL's throw. So RL's throw something that invokes this exception only when there is no value in it. Since we have a valid value for the book, so book optional returns the value that is inside the optional. But let's make it as null. So in this case, what happens is, since it does not have any valid value in it, so when you invoke RL's throw with an throwable exception, so what it does is, when it does not find any value in that, then it will raise this exception. So let me run this. Yeah, like we expected, it threw that exception, illegal argument exception, whatever we mentioned as part of RL's throw. Since this did not have any value, it just threw that exception. So that's what RL's throw will do. So that's a difference between RL's and RL's get, and then RL's throw. And hope this would have clarified the difference between these three. And thank you very much for watching this video. Bye bye.